Hi friends, welcome to the channel The Nurse. Here we are discussing about HAAD staff nurse exam practice questions and answers. HAAD means Health Authority of Abu Dhabi. HAAD staff nurse exam is compulsory to get a job in Abu Dhabi, Emirates of Abu Dhabi. That is one of the Gulf country. So question starts now. Before that, if you are not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe and support us. Question starts now. First question. An elderly patient is admitted to the hospital with swollen ankles. The best way to limit the edema of the feet is for the nurse to restrict fluids, apply bandages, elevate the legs, do passive range of motion exercises. Correct answer, elevate the legs. That is the best way to reduce ankle edema. Next question. Which of the following tasks require specialized education and should be performed by the nurse only after the training has been completed? Which of the following tasks require specialized education and should be performed by the nurse only after the training has been completed? Administering a dose of promethazine, that is Phenergan, via intravenous push. Applying a transdermal fentanyl. Instilling tobramycin ophthalmic solution. Beginning an intravenous infusion of cyclophosphamide. The correct answer is beginning an intravenous infusion of cyclophosphamide. Cyclophosphamide is a chemotherapeutic drug. It requires pre-medication and careful observation. Otherwise, it will cause so many side effects like myelosuppressions, urinary tract toxicity, etc. So it's read special education only performed after the training. Next question. The quantity of the blood pumped by each ventricle into the aorta per minute is called. Stroke volume, cardiac output, tidal volume, blood volume. Correct answer is cardiac output. Next question. A patient is diagnosed with diabetic ketoacidosis. The nurse would expect the physician to prescribe. Regular insulin IV, NPH insulin subcutaneous, glucagon intramuscular, mixed insulin subcutaneous. Correct answer, regular insulin intravenous. Next question. The apical pulse can be best auscultated at left second intercostal space, lateral to the midclavicular line, left second intercostal space at the left sternal border, left fifth intercostal space at the midclavicular line, left fifth intercostal space at the midaxillary line. Correct answer, left fifth intercostal space at the midclavicular line. Next question. The patient with liver cirrhosis receives 100 ml of 25% serum albumin intravenously. Which of the following findings would best indicate the albumin is having its desired effect? The patient with liver cirrhosis receives 100 ml of 25% serum albumin intravenously. Which of the following findings would best indicate the albumin is having its desired effect? Decreased blood pressure, increased serum albumin level, increased urine output, improved breathing pattern. Correct answer is increased urine output. Next question. The nurse should suspect that a patient has bleeding in the upper gastrointestinal tract when the color of the patient's stool is. Yellow, black, clay, red. Correct answer is black color. So fresh blood is usually seen in lower GI tract bleeding. And black color is usually seen in upper GI tract bleeding. Next question. The patient did not sleep well. The patient did not sleep well last night and is anxious about having a bronchoscopy later this morning. The priority nursing intervention would be. The patient did not sleep well last night and is anxious about having a bronchoscopy later this morning. The priority nursing intervention would be. Reassure and encourage expression of feelings. Administer the pre-medication a little earlier. Keep the patient occupied until the procedure. Explain the purpose of the bronchoscopy. Correct answer. Reassure and encourage the expression of feelings. That is the best nursing intervention for this patient. Next question. Which of the following action is the most appropriate when the nurse is responding to a patient during a tonic-clonic seizure? Which of the following action is most appropriate when the nurse is responding to a patient during a tonic-clonic seizure? Restrain the patient, protect the patient from harm, minimize noise and light stimulus, apply oxygen by mask or nasal cannula. Correct answer is protect the patient from harm. Next question. The nurse is preparing teaching plans for several patients. The nurse should recognize which of the following patient is at the greatest risk for fluid and electrolyte imbalance. The nurse is preparing teaching plans for several patients. The nurse should recognize which of the following patient is at the greatest risk for fluid and electrolyte imbalance. A 2-year-old patient who is receiving gastrostomy feeding. A 20-year-old patient with sigmoid colostomy. A 40-year-old patient who is 3 days post-operative with an ileostomy. A 60-year-old patient who is 8 hours post-renal arteriography. Correct answer is a 40-year-old patient who is 3 days post-operative with ileostomy. Because fluid is usually absorbing at large intestine. So, ileostomy patient is at risk for fluid and electrolyte imbalance. Next question. The police bring a prisoner into the emergency department who is in severe pain. When the nurse is assigned to this patient, the nurse should. The police bring a prisoner into the emergency department who is in severe pain. When the nurse is assigned to this patient, the nurse should. Ignore the prisoner because he deserves to be in pain. Give the prisoner the minimum amount of pain medication ordered. Tell the prisoner to be quiet as he is disturbing the other patients. Implement nursing intervention to relieve the prisoner's pain. Correct answer is implement nursing intervention to relieve the prisoner's pain. Next question. Collection urine bag should be emptied as necessary and at least every 8 to 9 hours to prevent. Collection urine bag should be emptied as necessary and at least every 8 to 9 hours to prevent. Pooling of urine in the tube, reflux of urine into the bladder, pulling on catheter, bacterial contamination. The correct answer is bacterial contamination. Next question. When caring for a patient with hepatic encephalopathy, the nurse may carry out the following orders. Give enemas, provide a low protein diet and limit physical activities. These measures are performed too. When caring for a patient with hepatic encephalopathy, the nurse may carry out the following orders. Give enemas, provide a low protein diet and limit physical activities. These measures are performed to minimize edema, decrease portal pressure, reduce hyperkalemia, decrease serum ammonia. Correct answer is decrease serum ammonia. Next question. The best example of documentation of patient teaching regarding wound care is. The best example of documentation of patient teaching regarding wound care is. The patient was instructed about care of wound and dressing changes. The patient demonstrated correct technique of wound care following instruction. The patient and family verbalized that they understand the purpose of wound care. Written instructions regarding wound care and dressing changes were given to the patient. The correct answer is the patient demonstrated correct technique of wound care following in the instruction. So next question. The nurse should place the automatic external defibrillator, that is AED, electrodes on the patient's anterior chest with one electrode placed below left clavicle and one below right nipple on the right mid-axillary line and other at mid-sternum, below the right clavicle and one below the left nipple on the mid-axillary line and one at the sternal notch. The correct answer is below the right clavicle and one below the left nipple. That is the correct placement of electrodes for defibrillator electrodes application. Next question. The nurse teaches a patient recovering from a total hip replacement that it is important to avoid. The nurse teaches a patient recovering from a total hip replacement that it is important to avoid putting a pillow between the legs while sleeping, sitting with the legs crossed, abduction exercise of the affected legs, bearing weight exercise on the affected leg for 6 weeks. Correct answer is sitting with legs crossed. Next question. A deficiency of which of the following vitamin can affect the absorption of calcium? A deficiency of which of the following vitamin can affect the absorption of calcium? Vitamin C, vitamin B6, vitamin D, vitamin B12. Correct answer is vitamin D. Next question. A 13-year-old girl with manifestations of rheumatic heart disease is admitted to the hospital. Which of the following laboratory blood findings would confirm that she likely has had a streptococcal infection within the past 2 weeks? A 13-year-old girl with manifestations of rheumatic heart disease is admitted to hospital. Which of the laboratory blood findings would confirm that she likely has a streptococcal infection within the past 2 weeks? Elevated hemoglobin count, elevated ASO titer, decreased ESR, decreased leukocyte count. The correct answer is elevated ASO titer. Next question. A patient with a severe protracted vomiting will often have what electrolyte abnormality? A patient with a severe protracted vomiting will often have what electrolyte abnormality? Decreased potassium and decreased chloride, increased sodium and decreased chloride, increased potassium and increased sodium, decreased sodium and increased chloride. The correct answer is decreased potassium and decreased chloride. Next question. The mother of a child with nephrotic syndrome asks with her child must be weighted each morning. The nurse's response should be based on the fact that this is important to determine the. The mother of a child with nephrotic syndrome asks why her child must be weighed each morning. The nurse's response should be based on the fact that this is important to determine nutritional status, water retention, medication doses, blood volume. The correct answer is water retention. Next question. When taking routine post-operative observation on a patient who underwent an explorative laparotomy, the nurse plans to monitor which important finding over the next hour? Serosanguinous drainage on the surgical dressing, blood pressure of 105/65 mmHg, urine output of 30 ml in the last hour, temperature of 37.6 degrees Celsius. The correct answer is urine output 20 ml in the last hour. Urine output less than 30 ml is indicated that is less blood flow into the kidney, that is maybe due to hypovolemia. So that is important for the post-operative, post-laparotomy patient. Next question. When the postoperative patient returns to the surgical unit, the priority is assess the patient's pain, measure the patient's vital signs, monitor the rate of IV infusion, check the physician's postoperative orders. Correct answer, measure the patient's vital signs. Next question, to prevent postoperative thrombophlebitis, which one of the following measure is effective? Elevation of leg on two pillows, using of compression stocking at night, massage the calf muscle frequently, performing leg exercise. Correct answer, performing leg exercises. Next question, to maintain the airway and promote respiratory function, the best position for the nurse to place the unconscious patient in the post-anesthetic care unit. Correct answer, lateral position. Next question, a patient has been taking aluminium hydroxide daily for 3 weeks. The nurse should be alert for which of the following side effects? Constipation, flatulence, nausea, vomiting. The correct answer is constipation. Aluminium hydroxide has side effects of constipation, so it should be monitored carefully. So question ends here. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and share this video and don't forget to subscribe our channel, The Nurse. Thank you.